来。
I need someone. I need my good friend Paul. Where's Paul?
Paul is still.
Paul, 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 Paul.
It's not here.
Can you do it for a moment?
Yeah, I will.
Okay.
Okay. 来，我们再找着我们的 Paul， 我们的最专业的翻译员。他不好意思，他刚刚应该去了洗手间，不好意思。哎，刚开完跟老师开完会，刚吃完了晚餐，一边吃晚餐一边开会，然后现在刚去了洗手间，待会很快，我们相信很快的速度就过来，赶过来，可不可以等？可不可以借用你的耳朵暂时听我讲？可不可以？哦，那还好。刘医生，祝你说那晚。
Oh, really? Oh, thank you. Well, big translation. Bonjour. Ah, that's nice. Are you ready for?A bit of exercise, huh? Okay, let's start like this.
来，站好。
We go like this.
准备，慢慢啊。来，
And now like this. And now we stretch. Yeah.
哇，伸展，伸
展。High, high up, 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 up,
up.
Come on. Come on. Okay, now we go to the right.
往右。
And then to the left.
往左。
And then to the back.
Oh,
and then to the front. Yeah. Now we do a real good exercise
for
the next 30 seconds.
30秒
I want all of you laugh like you never laughed before.
要狂笑，像你以前从来没有这样笑过。
Okay.Thank you. No laughing is known as one of the best exercises you can do.
笑是最好的练习之一啊。
People that laugh and that are happy live longer.
人会笑就会比较快乐，可以活得久一点。
We're going to be finishing the internet marketing part tonight.
今天晚上我们会玩这个，把这个互联网的行销把它结束。
But before I have a couple of things that I need to mention,
那我要先啊宣布几件事情。
Someone asked me for a copy, the English copy of my slides.
有人跟我要这个英文版本的这个投影片。
I can provide it to anyone, but I need your email address.
啊，我可以给你们，但是我需要你们的电邮。
So is this Shenwei?
曾维吗？有没有
？Okay, just give make sure you give me your email address.
电邮地址要给我。
And I'll send it. Now, if anyone else want the English slides, just email me or actually give me a sheet with your email address. Okay.
所以你们要这个一份这个拷贝的话，你就填一份这个联络单给我就好。但是上面要注明这个电邮地址，我就会寄给你。
And this person,
张小红。有没有张
？Okay, make sure you come see me. I will answer your question.
那确保您过来找我，然后回答您的问题。
Okay, if you give me a sheet like this,
如果你给我这张单子的话
，and it is for something for later on that I can answer, just make sure you put your email address.
所以如果你啊希望我以后可以给你答案的话，你一样把电邮给你给我，然后我会用电邮回答你。
I told you my last class that I was pretty good at sports.
那上一堂课我说过，我体育我很在行。
One thing I learned is that when you run or you swim, especially when you jog, like in the morning.
我发现各位早上要去跑步，要去游泳，尤其是跑步。
To make you feel better, just finished with a small sprint.
那如果你要让这个练习啊，最后有个好的结果的话，你要快跑一阵子，最后结尾的时候。
When you jog,
在慢跑的时候啊
，there are some, I don't know the right word, but it's some toxins.
那会有一些毒素
，that accumulates in your muscles.
它可能会累积在你的肌肉里面。
And then if you finish with a little sprint, it could be like 10 seconds. You run as fast as you can.
如果你慢跑到最后呢，你冲刺个大概十秒钟左右。
It will increase the blood flow in your muscles, and it will eliminate some of that toxin.
会把那个血液循环加快，进到你的肌肉里面去，把那个毒素放出来。
Will make you feel better much quicker.
会让你很快的就能够复原。
Now I have a request: is all the people that add those 2,000 contacts, direct contacts?
那有些人不是他们可以有认识2000个人，是不是？
You gave a business card to Linda.
把那个名片给这些人。
Okay, I would like 4 card. You bring that right away.
I mean those people.
The ones who gave cards to Linda because they had 2,000 contacts to bring to me 4 cards each. Business cards right away to bring them here.
Okay, 如果你昨天有把你的这个名片给 Linda， 是因为你有认识超过2000个人的话呢，现在请你把你的名片带上来，带四张上来，四张。
Okay, do that quickly.
四张快。
And I can tell you in my life, just put them on the floor. Okay, in my life, every person that has helped me, I have helped back much more.
每一个在我人生里面帮过我忙的人呢，我都会回报他们，回报的更多。
Okay, I cannot promise anything, but my policy is that if I receive, I give more than I receive.
那通常就是，如果人家给我，我就会给的更多回报。
谢谢。Thank you very much, everyone. I appreciate it. And the reason I'm asking is because Janet also would like a copy.
Hi, Janet. Janet 也希望有各位这个名片。
And also it serves as a lesson. So when you know people, you have a certain value.
那我给你一个教训啊。如果你认识别人，你自己就有一定程度的价值。
To people like me and like other people, you have to realize that there's something that you have.That not everyone has.
那你要体认到说，你对我像我这样的人，你就有自己的价值，你必须要自己有这个认知。
Okay, so we recognize that. Now, it doesn't mean that if you don't know over 2,000 people, that you're not valuable. That's not what it means.
这并不表示说你认识的人不到2000个，你就没有价值。这不是我要说的。
Okay, you're ready?
准备好了吗？
We're going to finish the internet.
我们把互联网说完。
10 minutes.
十分钟而已。
Then we're going to go to television.
然后我们看电视。
And television is because that's why I dress like this tonight. This is the suit of producers in America.
这就是为什么我今天要这么穿呢？因为美国的这个广告制作人穿的就是这个样子。
They wear a little jacket and
外套
shirt with
衬衫
no neck, just like this.
就像这样。
Very comfortable.
非常的休闲。
A good excuse for me not to wear a tie.
所以现在这是我好借口，我今天晚上就不用带领带啊。
Yeah.Okay, the last time when we finished, you had that screen.
我们上堂课结束的时候是看到这个画面，对不对？
And I was explaining that this platform, internet platform, was bridging television advertising to the internet.
那我跟各位说过，这个平台可以把电视跟网络结合在一起。
Now I'm bringing this to Asia.
现在我把这个带到亚洲里面来。
And the people that go through MoneyNU and BSC will be privileged because.They will probably be the first ones to be on that with the products that are good enough for that.
那参加过这个 BSE 还有我们 MoneyU 的朋友们，你们现在就占一个优势，因为你们的产品可能就可以放在这个上面，你们都知道了。
So that is my commitment to you because I control that.
那我向各位做这个承诺啊，因为现在这些市场主控者就是我本人。
So now it is. I just saved you about $100,000 US.
我大概就省了你$100,000的这个成本了。
Because that's what they have to invest before they get on that website in America.
因为啊，别人的话就要投资，先投资$100,000才有办法做这样的事情。
It sound good?
听起来不错吧
？Yes, good, 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 good. You know, when you control elements in your life, you can do things like that.
你人生有些项目是你能够掌控的话，你就可以做像我刚刚做的这样的事情。
And in business, my belief is that you need to be in control of everything.
那在做生意的话，我相信你每个项目你都要能够主控。
But a little secret I'm going to tell you.
那我要告诉各位一个小小的秘密啊。
When I was raising my little girl,
我在这个带我这个小女孩，我的女儿长大的时候啊
，I wanted her to drink her milk.
我要她喝她的牛奶。
And she didn't like milk.
她不喜欢喝牛奶。
So what I would do, I would put milk in the red glass, a red cup, and a blue cup.
那我怎么做呢？我会把牛奶倒到一个啊红杯子，还有一个蓝杯子里面。
I would say, okay, which one do you want?
你要喝哪一杯？
I knew the color. She always takes red. At that time, her favorite color was red, so she would take the red one.
那时候她因为最喜欢红色，所以她一定会挑红色那一杯。
She would drink her milk.
她会喝她的牛奶。
In her mind, she was in control.
她是能够去选择有主控权的。
She decided which glass she wanted.
她决定她可以喝哪一杯。
But in reality, I was in control because she drank the milk I wanted her to drink.
那现实上来说，其实真正主控的是我，因为我要她喝红色那一杯，她就喝了，对不对？
So the point is here that sometimes you might not appear to be in control, but you must be in control.
那我要告诉各位的就是呢，有时候你似乎啊没有再有那个掌控权，但是我要告诉各位，你一定要取得那个掌控权。
Okay, just keep that in the back of your mind. This is not the goal of the lesson to explain how to do it, but just keep it and it will develop. And eventually, by learning from the other speakers, you will understand what I mean.
请你放在你的心中，这个不是我们课的重点。但是当我们的课程越来越往下走的时候，你以后会慢慢开始了解到我刚刚讲这句话是什么意思。
谢谢。Okay, main thing for internet, you must be able to take credit cards or debit cards.
在这个互联网上面的话，如果买方要付钱的话，一定要用信用卡，透过信用卡完成。
Now I understand very clearly that in China, it's not nearly as available as it is in the rest of the world.
那我知道在中国，信用卡可能不像世界其他地方那么普遍。
But it is coming. It's coming fast.
但是信用卡以后一定会进中国，而且速度很快。
I'm in discussion presently with Bank of China and also American banks to establish the credit card and debit card or check cards, we call them, here in China.
那我正在跟中国的银行还有很多美国的银行联系，希望能够把信用卡带到中国里面来。
Okay, a debit card is a card like a credit card.That you give, and it's like writing a check or giving cash. It's taken directly from your bank account.
那有一种卡叫做付款卡，它跟信用卡非常的类似。那你用那个卡片，你就可以付钱，就像写支票一样，直接款项会从你的账户里面扣掉。
So you have to have access. You must have the money in the bank.
所以你必须要把钱先存在银行里面去扣款。
And it has to be very secure. The people must.Be comfortable buying products from your website.
而且要非常的安全，让人们信任这个互联网，在上面买东西。
Okay, everyone with me?
大家都懂吧
？Yes. Good.
很好。
Good. Okay. Again, do we have the handouts out already? Or
讲义是不是他们已经有了
？Are they out? Okay, they're coming. They're going to come with the handouts, and it's the same principle. Oh, actually, I'm sorry. My mistake. Not yet.
还不要发，抱歉，还不要发。
I forgot that you already have those handouts.
你们应该是已经有这份讲义了。
Okay, sorry. In the handouts of internet, you remember the principle, right?
记得这个互联网的秘诀吗？
The number.
原则。
The little number of the slide.
在这个你那个上面有一个号码，注意看一下。
Okay. So you just follow the number.
你就看上 Now, 左右上角是什么号码。
You can read as well as I can.In your notes, I'm going to cover only a few.
那都在你的讲义里面，所以我只谈其中几项啊。
Okay, so the main one is to give things away.
重要的是要送东西。
You must be able to give something away. It doesn't have to be a product.
这个东西不一定是产品。
It can be just information.
可能是资讯。
So it's not something that should cost you anything.
这个不用花你什么钱的。
You must make the order process very easy.
你必须要让这个订购的程序非常的清楚。
No, I talked about that yesterday.
昨天我谈过了。
It has to be easy to order, right?
很容易去订货。
You must give 100% money back guarantee.
你必须要那种不满意100%退款的这个保证。
Your sales will go like that.
这样你的业绩啊会往上冲啊。
And I can tell you by experience, people do not return.The stuff.
那我告诉你，根据我的经验，没人会要求退货的。
You might get some back, yes.
有些可能会啦。
But you will be making so many more sales because you give the guarantee, then it will offset many times the returns, the few returns.
但是因为你保证会退款，所以你的业绩绝对能够抵消你损失的那些部分，人家要求退货的部分。
Now there's a gentleman that came to me yesterday, and he said there was a mistake in my slide, my handout, saying that I forgot email.
那有一个先生跟我讲啊，说我的讲里面有个地方弄错了，我忘记电邮这个部分。
Who's that gentleman?
那位先生是谁啊？
Okay, I want to thank you.
我要谢谢您啊。
I've been using this for 6 years.
我用这个投影片用了六年呢、啊。
And nobody picked it up.
没有人抓到这个地方。
Nobody saw that.
没有人看到那个错误啊。
Thank you.
谢谢你，谢谢你。
This is, you know, anywhere and everything you're doing when you have the internet and on your web page, you must always put your address, email, phone, and fax numbers.
在你的互联网网站上，你一定要你的地址、电邮、电话和传真号码。
Now on the internet, you avoid to put the PO box. I don't know, does it exist here? PO box.
我们有没有那种邮政信箱啊？在邮局里面的信箱。
Postal box, you know what I mean?
你知道是什么意思吗？
You know, where the mail doesn't go to your house, it goes to, or your office, it goes to a box, and you pick it up at that box.
也就是这个信不会直接寄到你的家里，它会寄到邮局的一个信箱里面，然后你需要去领信的时候，你再过去一次领出来。
People don't like to order two addresses that have only a PO box because they don't know if it's real or not.
如果你只有一个邮政信箱放在上面的话，人家会不信任，不知道这样买好不好。
Now, when you send email, make sure you always have your name and contact information, your website address on your email at the end of your email.
你在寄电邮的时候，信件的最下面一定要你的名字、联络方式、你的网页、网址等等。
Can we have the mic, please? Second. Okay, anything else we can get here? So the other things that are there, basically, you know, you can just look at your notes and they're all there.
那其他东西都在讲义上，你可以自己看。
Go ahead.
老师刚才已经讲得很清楚了。但是我发现有些同学呢，还是没注意到这一条中间的有一个字是个错误。那就是列出你的地址、电话、传真，它上面写的不提供信箱。老师现在纠正的就是这个“不”字呢，要划掉它，应该是提供信箱。哎，就是317的那一个，极少的人了解互联网的秘密。中间有这么一条，列出你的地址、电话、传真，提供信箱，把那个“不”字划掉。不要不把这个不词要划掉。哎
，You ask him. Maybe we can ask him what he means. What's that?
Don't give them the PO box.
Oh, okay. Good. It's good. Thank you.
那请老师再跟大家讲一遍。
Oh, the PO box. I don't know if it exists here, but
不知道中国有没有。
Many foreign Many companies when they go to another country to sell products,
很多这个公司到另外一个国家去销售产品的时候
，instead of having an office and a street address,
他们啊啊、没有一他们有一个办 ，they don't have it,
they don't use it,
他们不用一个办公室，也没有一个地址
，they go to a post office,
他们到这个邮局去
，and the post office has walls of boxes, just little mailboxes.
邮局里面有一道墙呢，上面全部都是邮政信箱。
And you give that address. Each box, one box is yours. One box is yours. One box is yours. You have a key to open the box to get your mail.
那申请的人呢，自己就可以领到一个信箱，他们能够有钥匙去开这个信箱去领信。
Okay. That's a system that works in many, many countries, and that's a mistake when you want to market a product in another country. You use that kind of address. It doesn't work.
那很多国家都有这种邮政信箱的系统，但是你在互联网上面如果只用给他们邮政信箱让他们订货的话，这样是行不通的。
Okay, in other words, the conclusion for this part is basically that you use a real address.
换句话说，要给他们一个真正的地址就对了。
Okay, good. Good. Okay, now some links you have that I believe I didn't check on that one. Was that 318? I don't have. Show me 380. Okay, so you have them there, so I don't have to go over.
讲义上也有这张。
We'll save us a bit of time. That's more for information. Now, one main, very important element.
有一个很重要的要提醒各位。
Is email.
就是电邮。
Email marketing.
电邮的行销。
Janet mentioned a bit yesterday about.There could be some difficulty, some problem with email.
那 Janet 昨天曾经提到过，电邮可能会带来一些问题。
So all I want to say is that, and agree with her like she was saying, you don't buy a CD that costs, I know, maybe 100 RMB, and then you have like 30 million addresses, and you try to sell your product to those addresses.
那如果假设你一个碟片的这个产品呢，大概10块、20块美金，你不想说一次要。用电邮呢，就想办法能够把他们销售到3万人、4万人的手上。
I know in America and in Europe, the only thing that works presently is what is called double opt-in. I will explain.
那在欧美地区，我觉得真的行得通的呢，是所谓的自己选择要回函的这种电邮。
So double in opt-in means that
什么意思呢
？The People go to a website and they ask for some information.
有一个人他上到网站上去，他要求得到一些信息。
And because they don't find any information anywhere.
因为这个网页上面看不到他要的东西。
So they put their name and say, I want information on beauty products.
所以他就在上面填了一些资料，然后告诉这个网站的人说，我需要一些美容产品的这个信息好了。
And the website.Email them back and say, "Are you the person who asked for beauty products?"
那这个网站呢，就会寄一封信给寄一封回函给这个寄信的人，然后问他说，您是不是要跟我们索取美容产品的这个信息
？So they double check, making sure that it's the right person.
所以网站干什么呢？他再次检查是不是真的这个人有提出这个申请。
And if they say yes, well, the name is added to a list.
如果对方回答是的话，再把这个客人的名字放到清单里面去。
Then you can go out and buy that list and send. If you're selling beauty products, you can send your email to those people because they want that information.
如果你是销售美容产品的话，你就可以买这样子的清单，因为这些人可能就是要购买美容产品的人。
That clear?
懂不懂
？Yes. Okay. That's almost the only way that email will work.
这是电邮销售大概唯一的方式了。
Okay, good. Yes. I'm sorry. Explain double opt-in email. Oh, why? Okay, well, that's a good question. Question is why do I say that bulk email can destroy your business?
为什么我说你大量的寄这个电邮啊，会毁掉你的生意？为什么我这么说呢？
The bulk email is what you buy, like, you know, the CDs with millions of names, or through the internet you buy lists that they sell like tons, millions of names for very little money.
有时候你可以花很少的钱啊，买到一片碟，那个碟片上面有很多很多客户的这个名字和资料。
If you use that and you send an email saying come to my website to see my products,
如果你用这个方法大量寄电邮给这些名单上的人呢，然后跟他们讲过来买我的产品
，your site will be shut down in sometimes minutes, sometimes hours if you're lucky.
如果你如果这样做的话，有时候你的网站几分钟之内啊就会被人家关闭掉。如果你运气好，几小时后以后也会被人家关闭掉。
Because on the internet, you got thousands of people around the world that are protecting the internet against that.
因为互联网上面啊，有非常多的人啊，试图保护网站，不要让网站去做这种大量寄电邮的动作。
Now they're not paid. They're just people like ourselves here. Say, hey, I don't want that junk mail. And every time they are technicians that know how to shut down your website.
那这些人是不领钱的、啊，因为他们讨厌这种大量寄的垃圾邮件，所以啊，有些技术人员就有办法、啊。如果发现你有寄大量的邮件的话，就把你的网站把它关掉。
And then some of them will go to the extent that they will call you.
有些人甚至还会打电话给你啊。
And they will threat you.
然后啊，威胁你。
I have that.Experience myself.
我自己就曾有这样的经验啊。
I did it once many years ago.
很多年以前啊，我做了一次。
When it was okay to do it.
因为那时候做这件事情，人家还可以接受。
And I received that phone call because my name was on the name and address, and address was on the website and phone number.
那后来就有人打电话给我，因为我的网站上面就有我的联络方式，有我的电话。
So the guy says, "I'm going to kill you."
那个人就说我要把你宰了。
I'm going to your place and I'm going to kill you.
我要到你家把你杀了。
I stopped everything.
我就不再做了。
Yeah, so it never happened. Nothing happened. I don't know where the guy was from. Maybe he was from, you know, maybe from Europe, from China, maybe. I don't know, but it scared me.
我不知道那个人从哪儿打电话来，搞不好是从欧洲啊，中国，我不知道他从哪儿打来，但是我被吓到了。
And some of them will actually keep track of every time that your name comes up when you register a domain name.It will track you and shut you down again.
因为你去登记网域的时候是有资料的，所以这些人看到你大量寄垃圾邮件的时候，他就会追踪你啊，来找出你是谁。
That's why I'm saying it can ruin your business.
所以这就是为什么我说这样可能会毁了你的事业啊。
Okay,
懂吗
？The basic of the whole thing is to promote yourself.
重点就是你要用互联网来这个促销推销自己。
Any way you can promote yourself.
尽可能的去推销促销自己。
You know what to do now with Roger just before, right?
那 Roger 刚刚已经跟你们讲解很多次，你现在知道该怎么做了。
Did you like the class, Roger's class?
Roger 这个老师上的课你们还喜欢吧
？Was it good?
不错啊，
yeah,
对不对
？Good. All the things he talked about apply to internet and television that we're going to see after, and the retail stores that we've done before.
Roger 老师讲的这些观念啊，可以运用在互联网上面，可以运用在电视上面，还有我们之前说过的零售业上面。
So my saying here is that success is a learned behavior.
那所以我要告诉各位，成功是一种学习而来的行为。
You can learn success. It is not something that you were born with.
成功是可以学习而来的，不是天生的。
And there's a saying in people that are very successful, we say that success brings success.
那已经很成功的人都知道，成功会带来进一步的成功。
You take one success at a time.
一次抓住一个成功。
And you build on it.
然后慢慢的去累积。
Who knows how to eat an elephant?
有多少人知道怎么样吃一头大象的
？No, an elephant is big.
大象很大，对不对
？How do you eat an elephant?
怎么吃大象？
切成一小块，一片一片的吃。
Repeat it, please.
切成一小块，一片一片的吃。
Cutting in small pieces, one piece at a time.
一小块一小块，一次吃一块。
Now, don't ask me why a person will eat an elephant. I don't know.
你不要问我为什么人要吃大象，我不知道啊。
It's just an example.
只是个例子而已。
When the task is huge,
的任务非常庞大的时候
，one piece at a time.
一次做一步。
You're successful with one piece, you move on to the next piece.
一步成功了，再走下一步。
If you always do what you always did,
如果你一直重复以前的方法
，you will always get what you always got.
你得到的结果就会跟以前一样。
Do you get that?
懂不懂
？If you always do what you always did,
如果你一直用的方法都跟以前的一样。
You will always get what you always got.
那你得到的结果也会就跟以前的一模一样。
If you're doing something and it doesn't work, try something else.
如果做一件事行不通的话，赶快换一个方法做。
In marketing,
行销
，in your life,
你的人生
，everywhere,
到处都是这样。
Okay, very important. And what matters is what you do with everything that you're learning, what you're doing from this point on.
所以重要的是，从今天开始，你怎么就你的所学去做事的方法就很重要了。
Okay, so we're done, I believe, with internet.
所以互联网
，we've done retail before.
互联网已经结束了，零售业之前，在之前也说过了。
Now we're going to move on to television marketing.
所以接下来要谈的是电视行销。
You ready for that?
准备好了吗
？Good. Television is fun.
电视行销很好玩啊。
You're not supposed to see this right away.
你们不应该先看到这张的。
Okay, selling through television. You're selling a product on television. How do you do that?
在电视上去贩售一个产品，怎么做呢
？The way to do it, I'm going to talk about tonight, is called direct response.
那今天我要教各位的方法叫做直接回应。
It means simply that you're expecting a response back right away, a reaction from the viewer.
简单来说，观众看了马上就有反应。
I'm just going to have those there. You might recognize some. There's some that may be here already. Can we shut off a few lights? If
有些这个投影片这上面的东西，你可能已经不会认得出来。有人。
Anyone heard that?
灯可以放暗一些吗
？Yeah, and we'd like the handouts, please.
啊，现在可以发讲义了。
So that's just for you to look at while I'm talking, basically.
这只是让各位去看而已。
So direct response is very, very a great way to sell a product, and it's in direct line with what Roger just taught you.
直接回应是很有效的一个销售方法，跟 Roger 老师刚说的原则是一模一样的。
There has to be a unique selling proposition.
你必须要一个独特的销售提案。
Okay, those slides work exactly the same way. You have a number on top right of the slide.
现在你在讲义上面也有号码，是可以去对，你就知道是哪一张。
And then so you just match it. Okay. By the way, Roger was talking about those tech guys going using PowerPoint and the light go down. Well, the lights just came down.
你记得吗 ？Roger 老师曾经说过啊，技术人员做简报的时候，通常灯都要放暗，因为他放 PowerPoint 嘛。现在灯也放暗了。
So I'm that kind of guy that has to be just like that.
所以啊，我就是像那一种人啊。
But for a reason, because I don't like using that. I don't like using slides.
我本人不是那样的人啊，因为我也不喜欢投影片。
But when it's needed, it's needed.
但是今天上课需要，所以必须给各位看。
Okay, let's go.Ready, bonjour! A few eyes can open.
有些眼睛睁开来了。
Not too dark because everyone will fall asleep.
不要太暗，不然大家都睡着了。
Okay, that's something that I came out with a few years ago, many years ago actually.
好多年以前我就想出这个观念啊。
So the end or the result in the future,
未来的结果
depends on how it starts.Like this week, for example.
那取决于这个星期是怎么展开的。
But most importantly is what you do in between the beginning this week and the results you want.
那最重要的是，你这个星期的开始到最后你得到你的结果之间，你做了什么事情才是关键。
And that's what we're going to talk for the next couple of hours. Is how do we do it on television?
这就是我们接下来两个小时要说的。你怎么在电视上销售产品
？Now this is.You see, I'm the same teacher for three elements: retail, and the internet, and the television, right?
零售、互联网还有电视行销都是我教的，对不对
？The reason is simply because you have to work with those three elements at the same time.
为什么呢？因为你要同时运用这三项元素。
Many of the same elements, many of the elements are the same.
这三个项目有很多地方是共通的，是共同点。
There's an article that I had translated, and it is basically called, it says, more Chinese firms embrace the slick Western ads.
那这个报道上面指的是说，它的标题是啊，越来越多中国的这个公司啊，开始去拥抱那种非常简洁流利、制作精良的这个西方广告。
So the reason I'm putting that article in your handouts is simply to show you that, or to let you know that the way business is conducted on the Western side for marketing on television is what is coming here.
那我给各位看这个文章的目的就是告诉各位，西方的行销还有广告的手法已经开始进入这个地方了。
So just don't assume that what I'm talking about here, because examples are taken from Europe and America.That it doesn't relate to you. It does relate to you.
所以你不要假设说我的例子都是欧美地区的这个例子，那在中国就不适用。千万不要这样想，他们已经进来了。
The principles are the same.
原则都是一样的。
Now I was extremely surprised when I turned on TV at 2, 4, and 6 in the morning the first night I was here because I couldn't sleep.
那第一天晚上我到这儿睡不着，那早上2点、4点、6点的时候我打开电视。
And I saw that all the TV stations were on.
那我发觉所有的电视啊都还在广播播放节目。
I was told before coming here.
我来这之前呢
，that Television was on around 6-7 in the morning and until maybe midnight at night.
那有人告诉我说，中国的电视大概早上6-7点开播，然后晚上12点就结束了。
Now I see that, and that information was only from a few months ago.
那他跟我讲，这个朋友跟我提供这个信息的时候，只是几个月前的事而已。
And already I see the progress. Is this changing? It's coming fast here.
所以我马上就看到已经有所改变了，改变是很快速的。
So the information you're getting here about television marketing, not too many people in China know about this.
换句话说，各位现在学到有关电视的这些信息啊，中国还不是很多人知道啊。
Because the direct response segment where you want feedback right away from the consumer doesn't exist yet.
因为直接回应这个系统目前在中国还不存在。
Now it exists in Japan, in Korea.
日本、韩国。
A bit in Taiwan, Malaysia, a bit.
台湾还有马来西亚有一点点啦。
But they don't have the infrastructure in place to really control it.
但是他们目前还没有一个基础系统可以好好的掌控这整个制度。
And some of the stuff you'll see tonight are the basis of that infrastructure.
那今天晚上我谈的部分就是这整个基础建设的这个架构。
One thing the television allows you to do is to hit your market very strongly.
它可以帮助你的一点就是它可以让你很快速的去攻击你的市场。
I'm going to be using a lot of videos tonight because we're talking about television and television is visual.
那我会给各位看很多的影片，为什么呢？因为电视广告是视觉型的。
Now, on the first one here, I'd like you to pay attention on the physical reaction and the emotion of the people that are looking at the car passing by.
那我要各位注意看的是啊，等一下这里面的人，他们看到一辆车子的时候有什么反应？
Now, there's music, but there's no words.
它有音乐，但是是没有人说话的。
So it's good for any language.
所以你不用懂，也没不用说懂英文才能看懂。
But the question I'll have for you after is simply, what do you think the company, the car company, was looking for? What kind of market were they talking to?
但是呢，等一下你要跟我说，这个打广告的公司呢，它的目标市场在哪里
？Okay, ready?
好吧。
Ready,
准备好哦。
So what was the target market?
目标市场是什么
？Who? What is he trying to attract?
他想要吸引什么样的客户群
？What kind of people?
哪一种人
？Just shout it.
大声吼出来。
比较年轻。
少儿。
要引起关注的。
Okay. Good.
好。
Somebody else?
还有别人吗
？I'm sorry. Say it like.
地位比较。
OK
啊，地位比较高的人。
OK， there must be other reasons。
还有其他，一定有其他。
有家庭的，有宠物的。
哦。Did you see dogs or cats there? I didn't see that.
有，我看到猫狗，是不是？
Oh yes, that's true. You're right. Yeah, that's true.
没错，有狗、啊。
I never saw that.
我根本都没有看到、啊。
But that's not what they're.
但是那不是。
Okay, one more.
表示还有吗
？Okay, there's two main elements on this ad.
这个广告有两个主要的部分。
First, the first answer was probably the closest. People who like to be seen, or they like the prestige of having a Mercedes Benz.
第一个可能是喜欢买这个奔腾的这个轿车的人，他们希望能够拥有那种优越感，那种地位感。
So they kind of made it very nice that people will look at you, you will feel good.
那你开这个车子经过的时候呢，很多人呢、啊、都会看着你，会让你感觉到很这个很好。
Now, in North America, the average car is around $37,000.
那在这个欧美地区呢，这个汽车的平均价格大概是37,000块美金。
So that is, let's say, 150,000 RMB.
大概是150,000人民币。
Okay, 300,000 RMB.
30,000人民币。
So that is what people pay in average.
这是一般人平均付的这个价格买车子。
We don't see very well here, but that's under $30,000.
那这边如果看不太清楚啊，它的价格不到30,000美金。
So I don't know about here, but in America.
我不知道这儿的价格，但是在美国、啊。
When you buy a Mercedes Benz, or when you drive a Mercedes Benz, you're somebody.
你开奔驰轿车的话呢，表示是你有头有脸的人啊。
You can sell a lot of insurance with the Mercedes.
Yeah,
You can sell a lot of insurance. No, the insurance people, insurance salespeople drive Mercedes.
Oh, oh, 在美国就有很多这个保险业的人就是开奔驰啊。
Because there's a perceived value that they are successful.
因为这样会让那个人大家有认为这个人很成功，这种认知的价值。
I'm using that example because of the exercise that Roger did, of course.
那我用这个当一个例子，因为刚刚 Roger 老师也做过类似的练习。
But the message here is that for under the price of an average car, you can be in a Mercedes and you can be proud of driving a Mercedes.
那这边这个信息是什么啊？你只要付低于平均价格的这个价格呢，你就可以开一辆奔驰的汽车了。
Okay, so television allows you to hit your market very, very targeted.
所以电视广告可以让你去锁定你的市场去攻击。
Now you can hit it again, but a little different twist.
而且你可以再次的攻击，但是其中有一些调整。
Now I'll explain this video here.
那我会解释一下这一段。
Basically, a man going to see his doctor, and the doctor says, "You're 40. You have 45, 50 years max to live. You better get your things in order."
那这个人去看医生，然后医生看了以后就跟他说，你现在大概40岁，你大概最多还只剩40-50年可以活了。那既然是这样的话，你的人生啊，一定应该要好好的去享受一番。
There's nothing wrong with the man. It's just the man is the target. I don't want to give the answer. No, don't translate. Just say if you translate it's because I gave the answer.And I don't want to give the answer.
那我不要给你们答案啊，你就看看这个人。
Okay, so basically, it is nothing wrong with the man. It's told by the doctor that you're average age person and you have about 45, 50 years to go.
所以这个人呢，他没有生什么病，只是医生跟他说，根据平均寿命来看的话，你大概还能再最多活40-50年。
What is it?
I don't know quite how to tell you this.But you've only got 40 years left to live. Maybe 45. 50 tops. You might want to get your things in order.
Okay, what is the market? Who are they trying to get?
市场是什么？
Okay, I don't think so. Not for this one.
我不觉得是这样啊。
Come on, come on.
Cherish your life.
Okay. Right. Let's take one there, first one.
如果连说不加分，直到花了几个步骤。Okay,
so I see here that how can I the way you have been brought up in Asia is different from America.
那亚洲人这个成长的这个模式跟这个可能教育的方式跟欧美地区是不一样的。
Because I've never been to, I never presented this, and I've presented that a long time. Many times, nobody, I was always able to get the answer right away.
那我已经讲这一套演讲讲很多次了，每次就很快都能听到答案了。
And I'll explain you why.
那我跟各位解释为什么。
Is because of the way that just the point is that you have to be very careful when you spend a lot of money on an ad on TV for one region or one country and bring it to another one.
当你在某一个地区啊，某一个国家又花了很多钱打一个广告的时候啊，如果你要把这个广告移植到另外一个国家去的话，你要非常的小心。
If you don't understand the way people think.And the people act in that other location. It could be just regional, or it could be the country itself. If you don't understand how it works and how people are brought up and all that, you will lose a lot of money.
如果你不知道你要打广告的那个区域或者是国家，那个人民的想法是什么，他们受教育的方式是怎么样的话，你在那边打广告就会非常的小，就可能风险非常的大，可能会很多的损失。
The target market here of Mercedes is simply some people that when they get around 40 years old.In average, they have finished raising their kids.
那基本上这个广告的目标群众、目标客户就是那些大概45岁到50岁的人，然后他们的孩子都长大了。
They have a good situation. They have like if they have a business, their business is now going well.
那搞不好他已经有事业了，现在事业在这个年龄大概已经做得不错了。
They worked hard and they deserve a break.
他们工作很努力，需要休息一下了。
So you need to drive a nice car.
你要开辆好车。
Go to the beach,
然后到海边去
swim and do all kind of things.
什么都可以做
And the best way to do it is in the Mercedes.
那唯一的方法就是开辆奔驰去做
And again, the price under $30,000.
再一次，价钱还是不到$30,000啊
Okay, let's try to the next one.
下一个广告
I want to show you how a direct response ad looks.In America,
我要跟各位给各位看一下这种直接回应的广告在美国长了什么样子。
And I'll have much more after, but I want to make a few points on this one in particular.
那我先讲其中的重点啊。
You wouldn't do this to your expensive leather couch unless you had the incredible Color Renew from the makers of liquid leather.
Hey, I'm 41, and I'm in the best shape of my life.And I can tell you, Bowflex really does work.
As a special bonus, everyone who calls today will also receive a 30-day free trial membership in America's...
It's only $19.95. Call now and we'll also include the rest of the Beachbody collection, a $59 value for just $1. And if you don't get them thighs, just send it back for a refund. It's guaranteed.
And I'm going to show you some country fun. A great new collection from Cornerstone Promotions.
Hey, baby!
So there were five different clips there.
五段不同的影片
And so just to give you a little feel of what direct response is, every one of them were asking you to do something. Call now or click on the screen because those ads were made for internet, television and internet, so you can click on your screen on the internet.
那这个广告只给各位看一下，熟悉一下这种直接回应的广告是什么样子。每个广告都会要求你采取行动。举例来说呢，你可以按一个钮呢。那这个就可以订购你的产品。
I don't want to do it again. Here we go. Okay. Glamour versus reality.
华丽和现实啊。
I don't want you to make that mistake to think that if you're going to have your product on TV, you're going to be rich.
那我不想各位以为说只要你的产品能上电视你就会有钱了
You heard what I said, right?
听到了
Many, many people lose their shirt by putting products on television
很多人因为把这个产品放到电视上面啊结果就啊损失了很多钱
And that, I don't want that to happen to you
我不希望这种事发生在你身上
Does it translate well, glamour? Is that, okay, it's really glamorous? Okay, I want to make sure that because A lot of people look at television as their way to, I'm good.
很多人看到电视就觉得是一个很华丽，可以带你华带给你华丽的人生，让你自己觉得你自己很杰出。
I'm on TV.
我已经上电视了。
And then going home and no money to buy food.
就回家以后没钱买吃的东西。
It happens a lot, and it's very important that you be careful with that, not to get in that trap.
所以你不要掉到这个陷阱里面啊！常常人就掉到这个陷阱里面。
In business, nothing happens until a sale is made.
在做生意的时候，除非你能够进行销售，销售能够完成，否则啊，什么事情都没有发生。
So it could be the nicest product, the nicest infomercial, the nicest show on television. If it doesn't sell, nothing will happen to your business.
如果、啊、你有个很好的很好的产品，你有很好很好的广告都上到电视上去了，但如果卖不出去的话，你的事业还是停滞不前，什么都没发生。
And that's a statement by a man that has sold over 16 billion RMBs on television worth of products.
那说这句话的人呢、啊，他透过电视销售产品，他的营业额达到啊160亿人民币。
A lot of products, right?
很多产品透过电视卖，对不对？
Lot of money.
他赚了很多钱啊。
He knows.
所以他懂，他会说这句话。
Okay, the fact of advertising.
广告的一些事实。
The facts provide the information.
事实会提供信息。
But the emotion provides the interpretation.And the action.
但是情绪呢，会提供诠释以及行动。
Okay, that's a big statement, but basically what it means is that exactly what Roger was saying. You have to get to the emotion.
那基本上这就是 Roger 老师说的，你要去干嘛？激起人家的情绪。
Because the emotion will make you buy.
因为情绪让你愿意去购买。
So you have to get to the emotion of the people in order for them to buy, just like Mercedes did with those two ads we saw earlier.
就像奔驰的这两个广告一样，你必须抓住人的情绪，让人们去购买。
I want to go through a bit of terminology.
那接下来我要介绍几个术语啊。
So that you understand and you sound smart when you talk to other people about commercial and television.
这样呢，你在跟别人谈广告啊，谈电视的时候，人家觉得你很聪明，都会用术语啊。
Now, I'm not sure how it translates in Chinese, but the word, the terminology that we're using in English is infomercial, is what you do when you have you try to sell something on television.
那在国外，在美国呢，要在电视上卖东西的话，你可以透过一个叫做美国商业购物频道。那我不知道中文有没有这样子的翻译，有没有类似的东西。
But you have two kinds. You have short form and you have long form.
但是在商业这个购物频道上卖东西的话，广告有两种。第一个是短式的，第二个是长式的。
Short form can be 30, 60 seconds, 2 minutes.
那短式的呢，大概30秒，然后到大概最多2分钟。
Long form is half an hour.
长式的话大概是半个小时的广告。
In China it's different. You go with, I believe it's 8 second segments.
那在中国好像不一样，每节大概是八秒钟而已。
So we have to adjust the time.
所以我们要调整这个时间呢、啊。
Okay, we have direct response. I already explained to you what it was.
我刚刚说过直接回应了。
Revenue share
分享利润
is a very,
营收
sorry, very important segment.
这是一个很重要的部分。
What it allows you to do is to advertise your product on television at no cost to you.
也就是你在电视上打广告啊，是不用花钱的。
The way it works is that you go to a TV station and you tell them, I have that product to sell, I have that video, and every piece that will be sold, I will give you a commission.
那你跟这个电视台说啊，我有个广告，你帮我打。那如果每次透过这个广告，我卖出去一件产品，那我就让你抽这个佣金。
So we'll share the profit.
我们分享这个营收。
Is that a good idea?
是好主意，对不对？
Your product is on television. It doesn't cost you anything if it doesn't sell.
你的产品上电视了，如果卖不出去，它不用花你广告费，免费。
I like that.
我喜欢这个点子啊。
The difficulty is that it doesn't exist yet in China.
那问题是中国还没有这种形式。
And this is what I'm bringing to China.
那我正要把这个系统带到中国来。
Because it requires a system.
因为它需要是一个系统。
And I have the ability.To do the system because I've done it in America.
那我就有能力建立这个系统，因为我在美国就已经完成了。
What we call cash buy is when you have to buy the airtime.
那另外一个是用现金买时段，就是要买这个广告时段。
Upsell, I will explain when we get to that, but basically is when you buy a product, you're trying to sell, or when you're selling a product, you try to sell another product.
第二，下一个延伸销售，就是你卖了一个产品出去，然后你一定要试着再卖一样产品给客人。
There was a product selling on television that was called Contour Pillow.
那在这个我记得有一个广告，他卖的产品是一种枕头啊。
It was a pillow you put between your legs to sleep so that you know your legs are in alignment.
那他这个枕头可以夹在两腿之间，这样你睡觉的时候两腿会非常的笔直。
They were selling the pillow for under $20. Let's say under 150 RMB.
那这个枕头很便宜啊，大概还不到20块人民币。
But the average sale with the upsell.
但是透过这种延伸销售方法所得到的这个营收啊。
Because when you would call to order the pillow, they would sell you another pillow and a mattress and this and that.
为什么？因为你打电话过去要买这个枕头，那个对方呢就进一步的销售，你可能要买床垫啊等等其他的东西。
The average sale was over 800 RMB.
那平均的销售额是超过800块人民币。
Okay, very important. The upsell, you make the money there.
所以延伸销售是很重要，可以赚取利润。
What we call HSN here is called TVSN.
那还有一个叫 HSN， 也就是这边的 TVSN。
And also QVC and there are other companies. Those are home shopping stations.
那这些是所谓的家庭购物频道。
They sell products all day long.
他们整天就是在卖东西。
There's no nothing else, no movies, no sport, no news, no nothing. Only selling products all day long.
没有电影啊，或者什么体育节目，整个电视台整天就是在卖东西。
If you're selling a service or selling insurance, for example, or if you're an engineer or you're a doctor, you're selling service, or if you're a bank, you want to sell your debit card or whatever, you use lead generator.
那如果你是销售，不管你销售什么啊，你要销售你的产品或者是服务啊，或者是你要销售那种付款卡的话，它可以带来让你带来更多新客户的来源。
So basically, you're getting leads from television and then you follow up with the telephone.
换句话说，你透过电视啊，有人会跟你联络，这样你就有他的联络资料，这样可以取得更多的讯息。
Now you see this little logo here.
各位可以看这边这个小标志。
You'll see this more and more and more in China.
以后中国一定会常常看到这个标志。
Might not look exactly the same, but would be similar.
可能长得不一样，但是会非常的类似。
It means that the product has been seen on television.
这表示这个产品曾经在电视上出现过。
And people, whether they are from here or from America or from Europe or anywhere, the tendency is to believe that if it's on TV, it must be good.
不管你是在哪里，在中国还是在欧美地区，如果看到这个标志，说这个产品在电视上出现过的话，你就觉得这个产品是比较好的。
Okay, so those are the terms we're going to be using.
所以我们用很多这些术语啊。
Can we have the mic, please, for a question here?
这边有一个问题，可以把话筒传过去吗？
Yeah, just keep your hand raised, and he's going to bring your mic. Okay, there's several ways to bring products to television.
那把产品到电视上有几个方法。
Okay, just get ready for your question. I'll be right back. In commercials.
第一个商业购物频道。
That's what we talked about earlier. You know that.
我们刚说过了。
Put on television. You need direct response. You're looking for direct response.
你要的是直接的回应。
Or you buy advertisement time.
或者是你买广告的时段。
Those are commercials like we saw with Mercedes.
像刚那个奔驰的广告就是这样。
I heard that somewhere, I don't know if it's Taiwan, Malaysia, that they sell cars through television.
那我不知道是谁说的，很像在台湾还是马来西亚，说是可以在电视上卖车子啊。
Who told me that?
是谁说的？
Someone told me that this week. Yes, that is Taiwan that they sell cars through television. It won't happen in America.
在美国就行不通啊。
In Europe, I don't think neither. It's too high of a price.
因为价格太高了，在欧美大概也行不通啊。
So we don't know. Maybe in China it will happen. We don't know.
搞不好中国可以，这我们就不知道了。
Home shopping is what I mentioned earlier.
刚刚我提到家庭购物频道。
Stations that are open all day just by selling product.
那这个电视台24小时都是在销售产品。
But you should also take advantage to talk shows and news media and all those that don't charge you. They're just looking for news.
那你可以运用媒体啊，如果他们要新闻题材的话，你可以就利用他们，或者是什么脱口秀等电视节目也可以。
Okay, go ahead with your question, please.
谢谢。 我是从1993年就和中国的各个媒体打交道，一直到现在。所以我想给您介绍一下中国的电视广告的情况。您所说的第一个，拿产品卖出去再给电视台的，比如说一盒产品是100块钱，当打广告卖出去一盒时候给电视台20块钱，这样的做法是在1995年的时候就已经发生了，而且运行到了1996年、97年的时候就运行不下去了，因为很多的产品打了广告之后卖不出来广告费，然后呢厂家没有办法，就他又没有现金，就把货给了电视台，结果电视台没有办法，他自己成立了一个电视广告产品商店，然后他又没有办法，他又在自己的电视媒体上做这个电视广告产品商店的这个广告，然后同时厂家也在卖这个产品，在其他的商场也卖这样的产品，然后这个电视广告产品商店的产品要比其他商场里卖的产品要低得多，所以这样造成了市场上的混乱。结果到了1997年、96年年末的时候，这种做法在中国大陆就已经行不通了。好，谢谢。
Good, very good. Well, thank you. That really proved the point or shows the point I was saying. The infrastructure is not there.
那这证明了，充分证明了一点，这个基础建设还不在。
And that's why I'm here. I want to.
这是为什么我要来这边？我把基础建设带进来啊。
Okay, bonjour. It's hard to stay awake this time of the day, right?
现在要各位醒着有点困难，对不对？很辛苦啊。
Some of you woke me up at I don't know 5:30 this morning. Who was up at 5:30 this morning?
今天早上五点半，谁把我吵起来的
？You were up at 5:30.
你们五点半都还没睡啊
？If you don't mind, I'm going to be running out of time. Keep your question and have some time at the end for questions.
如果有问题的话，稍后再问，因为我们时间不够了，好不好？
I really want to go through this, and there's a lot of things. I'll be going very fast. Please stay with me. There's information that is important. You might not feel it's important now, but it's important for you to know. So then, when you talk to people about that, you look smart, and you are smart.
那这个讯息呀、啊、很重要。现在看起来可能没有那么重要，但是以后你跟别人去谈这些东西的时候，别人就会觉得你是专家。那事实上，你就是这么聪明，是专家。
Jason is what, Miss BSC? Miss BSC, BSC. Stand up, now you...
我们看到 BSE 小姐在那边、啊。
Okay, there are different goals when you advertise, and you must know, you must understand what your goals are, and it's very simple on television when you do direct response.
那广告的目标是你必须要非常的非常的清楚，如果是在电视上卖的话，你要的是直接回应。
Direct response always for two things. It's sales.
直接回应有两个目标，第一个是销售。
So you're trying to sell your product through direct response.
销售产品透过直接回应。
Or you're trying to generate leads.
第二个，建立新的客户来源。
Because it's a service or it's an item that is maybe too expensive to sell on television.
因为有些服务可能太贵了，在电视上卖不出去，但是可以让你增加客源，增加曝光率。
And almost everything else, I'm not saying.Everything, because there might be some exception, but almost everything else is about exposure and brand recognition.
那最重要就是可能我不知道其他地方怎么样，但是我觉得很重要一个因素就是增加曝光率，还有品牌的识别率。
So I'm sure, I know, in Xi'an, is it Xi'an? Xi'an, X-I-A-N.
Xi'an.
Xi'an. It's a big city here.
在西安是一个大城。
Big city in China.
大城市，中国的大城市。
Northwest of here.
在西北方是不是
？You must know that. If I know that I'm from Canada and I know about Xi'an, you must know that.
如果加拿大我都知道西安，你们应该也知道西安啊，对不对
？Anyone know that city?
你们知道西安这个地方吗
？Okay, good. They have a big manufacturer, McDonnell Douglas, big airplane.
那边有一个麦道公司，很大的一个飞机制造厂。
And they advertised, they did advertise on television.
他们也在这个电视上有打广告的。
Do you think they were trying to sell big airplanes through television?
你觉得他们想要透过这个电视来卖这个卖道的飞机吗
？No, 哎，
不对。
No, they were not trying to sell that.
他们不是要卖飞机的。
First, the people watching television are not the one buying the airplanes. It's the people that are running the airline companies that do buy the airplanes.
第一个，看电视人不可能买飞机嘛，要买飞机的是航空公司嘛。
So it was exposure, brand recognition.
所以为的就是增加曝光率，品牌的识别率。
Good. The rules to follow.
规则。
When you're advertising on television and anywhere else.
在这个电视上打广告的时候，不管在哪儿。
Know what Roger was talking about is unique selling proposition.
Roger 刚刚有说过独特的销售提案。
It has to be real.
它必须要是真的。
You must tell the truth.
你要说出真相，实话。
And you must have on television have testimonials.
在电视上一定要推荐的证言、证词。
So you have people trying your product and they tell you what they think and you record that and you use that for your advertisement.
如果有人使用了产品满意了，你要把它录影下来，让他们在电视上说给大家听。
Okay, you have to create the need and the desire.
创造这个需求或者是欲求欲望。
Very easy on television, you just show them what the pain is.
很简单，在电视上让他们知道痛苦在哪里。
What the bad situation or the problem is.
让他们知道他们的问题是什么。
And then you show the solution.
然后给他们一个解决的方法。
Okay, and that exactly what Roger was talking about the pain. It's really what you're looking for is what is that people want.A solution to.
那这个就像 Roger 老师说到的一样，到底客户的痒处在哪里？你要怎么去烧它
？Now you have to make the offer unique and very compelling. People want to buy it.
你的提案要非常的独特，让人家迫不及待的想要买。
You need to have your product. If you're selling your product on television, it must not sell in the stores.
如果你要在电视上卖东西的话，这个产品不能在外面的商店也卖的。
So you do it before.
所以你必须要在之前卖。
Now, if you do it, because there are some exceptions.
有些例外，如果你是这么做的话。
If you do it, it has to be a different package or a different offer.
如果你要用在电视上还有商店里面都卖的话，记得包装要有一点不一样，而且可能提案也不一样。
There has to be something different.
必须要两个产品有所区隔。
It has to be, you have to tell them it's an exclusive offer.
你要跟他们说是独家提供。
And there has to be some reward for ordering now.
而且现在就购买的话，是有一些回报的，有报酬的。
And it has to be a limited time.
而且必须要限时抢购。
You know, you make it compelling. It's that if you don't buy it now, too late, you can't buy it.
你让他们觉得说，现在不买的话就太迟了，就买不到了。
So during the commercial, it tries to prove to you or convince you that you need the product.
所以在广告打广告期间是说服客户他们必须要买。
And at the end it tells you you need to order it now.
而且最后跟他们说现在就要订购。
Otherwise it will be too late.
不然就太迟了。
You must offer a money back guarantee.
必须要退钱的退款的保证。
I was going to tell a story, I won't say it. We're running short in time. To say that there's many things that I have to cut down because we're running out of time already.
用时间不够，所以很多内容要讲得很精简啊。
And it has to be called to action.
而且要人家采取行动。
Now I'm assuming I'm giving time for a break, right? Is that for a break? Okay, we're going to take a 5-minute break. Wake up, put water in your face because you're coming back. There's some information, very important information I have to give you again.And then we'll get to more exciting things after a little while.
So we 要休息五分钟，你在脸上泼些水啊，赶快醒过来。等下回来以后，还有更多更重要的资讯要告诉各位，然后会越来越精彩的。
I need you to stay with me, okay? So
我希望你们都醒着。
Go take your 5 minutes.
所以五分钟休息一下。
Okay, ready?
好。